Wait, what's he doing? He's dragging the leg. Oh my goodness, he's clowning around now. Okay, I haven't seen that one yet. Hello, everybody. SGU here today with my buddy Joe Broadway and his road to the show with the New York Yankees, hanging out in the clubhouse here. About to get a little visit from one of our coaches.
An all-star player receives a check-in from one of his coaches.
I think some of those are kind of funny. That was the hitting coach activating a fielding two-time boost. I don't know why that works out that way, but that is what happened. And so we do some more training, we sim a few games, and we're coming up with a series in Detroit here, four-game series in Detroit. Let's look at the career stats before we get playing. 361 Broadway bombs to this point in his career. Over 1,500 hits. And so we are ready to come on in to Comerica Park and take on the Tigers. They're 23-23, right at 500. We wish we were playing 500 ball right now, 20-27. And we got to get our rears in gear and get into the race in the AL East. So Mr. Joe Broadway singled out in your pregame presentation right there, representing the Yankees. And now he'll step in the box, those 23 home runs on the season. Wow, that's quite a few to start things off here. Maybe he'll be going after his own record and try and best that this year. This is deep to right field, but not nearly deep enough. It's caught ahead of the warning track, and he is out. Runner will have to stay at first base. How about next time, Joe? What do you got for a follow-up at bat? He's 0-for-1 and looking for a much better result. Detroit up 2-1 right now. You got a runner on first base. This ball's hit in the air. This one's to center field. And it is back, and it is caught. I think he hit that one even farther. But again, not far enough. It stays in Comerica Park, and it's just another out. By all means, keep pitching to him, though. He'll hit one of these out of the ballpark. I am sure of it. How about with the bases loaded? Saving it for a grand slam, possibly? Well, he hits the ball well, and he hits it to center field. It's going to be caught, however. Well, this time around, at least it'll drive home a run. Sacrifice fly, runner scores from third base, and they cut the deficit to 3-2, so at least it's a productive flyout. And again, you know, he hit the ball hard right on the line, but you will see coming on over here making the catch. No chance of throwing the runner out, so they score the run. 3-2. Just 0-for-2 because that last at-bat doesn't count. The sacrifice fly doesn't count against him. And, well, he's going to need more than that this time, as they're down 6-2, and, well, also there's nobody on base. So this ball hit to center field, and it is caught. 0-for-3 now officially, and it looks like the Yankees are running out of opportunities here possibly to get back in this game. Broadway will get another at-bat, though. Oh, yeah, it's 8-2 now. Awesome. And he pops it up. Foul territory. Can the catcher find it? Oh, yeah, he's got plenty of room. Makes the catch, and that's a disappointing at-bat right there. Disappointing game overall. He did have the sacrifice fly, but no hits for Broadway. And Detroit goes down in defeat, 8-2 in game one of this four-game set. And we got three more baseball games here in Detroit to prove our worth, but, you know, this kind of follows the season pattern so far. Just not getting going. We're just sputtering, spinning our wheels. 20-28 coming into this ballgame. Two outs in the first inning. Broadway comes up in that customary three-spot hitting. He's going to ground out. That's something new. All flyouts last game. This time, he starts with a ground out. All right, well, no score. After half a frame, we'll move this along and see, oh boy, how the pitching's doing. It's not doing well at all. We give up 5 runs by the next time we get it bat. And there you go. There's a line drive to right center, and it's going to find the gap. Broadway's going to have 2. Is he going to go for 3? Yes, he is. He's not even stopping, not hesitating. Head first slide, and that is a triple for Joe Broadway coming through right here when his team needs to get jump started, and that's exactly what he does. Now, doesn't really hit the ball far to begin with, but it found the gap beautifully, and look at this. Look at this hustle out of Broadway. This is awesome. Just going from first to third as if he were Skeeter Rabbit or something. And he's on over there. But now with 1 out, they got to try to come through and get him home. That's just a little dribbler to the pitcher who not only bobbles it a little bit, but gets the out at first. And Broadway's got to retreat back to the bag at third. An unproductive out. Let's see if they can get the run home with two outs. It is hit to the third baseman, Weekly. Popped up is caught, and they strand Broadway and his triple at third base. It's still 5-0 Tigers. Gross. That's no fun. Not fun at all. We got to do better than that. So Broadway's got the triple, but his team's got no runs. You got a runner at first base. Can we do something about it? Well, you know what? They can't catch it if you hit it into the seats, and that's exactly what Broadway does. Deep to left field. Gone. Oh, there's a new one. He's running backwards, guys. Oh, man. Luckily, he still touched second base. Can you imagine if he would have tripped and fallen right there? That would have been funny. Oh, wait. You're kidding me. They got the third baseman to fake taking the picture? You've got to be kidding me. I love that one. I don't think the Tiger manager would approve so much. But that is sweet. It's 5-2 now, the two-run homer. Let's watch the replay as he connects off the lefty. And where does this thing end up? Yeah, it's way back there, all right. Very much worthy of the moniker of a Broadway bomb. So he's got the hardest parts of the cycle done, home run and triple. Well, let's see if in a 7-3 game, he can get them a little bit closer. Bullet shot to third base, and oh, man, quick reflexes. He gloves it, and Broadway lines out. Ah, shucks, he says, or something like that, as he goes back to the dugout. Here he's going to backhand a ball, and with two outs, throw across the diamond and get his man. Well, it's a good thing, because you wouldn't want that 11th run scoring for Detroit. Jeez, it's 10-3. Just what a whitewash here. They're going to lose the first two games of the series, and this one, not even close. Man, oh man. So, a good day at the plate. Much better for Broadway, personally. The home run and the triple had a little fun, but that's about all the Yankees had fun with today, as they lose yet again. All right, well, let's see what Game 3 of this series brings as we are trying to avoid going 10 games below 500 again. It'd be 20-30 with another loss. All right, Joe's got 24 Broadway bombs now. He can make it 25 today if he reaches the seats again. You got a runner at second base, and oh, that's nice. Just going with the pitch to right. He gets the base hit. The runner is going to try to score. The throw coming in is going to be relayed and not in time. So it's an RBI single starting off for Broadway, trying to get that team fired up. There you go. See, boys, take my lead. And he just does a great job with the pitch outside half of the plate. Doesn't try to pull it and ground to short or anything like that. He just hits it through the hole on the right side of the infield. So now with one out, he is taken off for second base. That is just a little blooper right in front of the mound that the pitcher cannot catch in the air. He's got to throw on over to first to get an out. Broadway standing at second now, but there are two outs. So let's see what they can do with a 1-2 count. Ball is put in play. Ball is down for a hit. Broadway around third, and he's coming home. He will score standing up. Tack another one on for the Yankees. It's 2-0. They're sick and tired of losing. They want to get a win today, and they're playing like it so far. Okay, Broadway up for his second at bat. Looking to add on to what the Yankees have done so far, which is now a 3-0 lead. You got a runner at first base, and you've got a deep fly ball. He kind of does the holstering of the sword with the bat flip right there, as he knows this is absolutely gone. Okay, here we go with the hijinks, going backwards around second base again. Will he stop to take the picture? Will the third baseman oblige again this time? Oh, nope. Oh. Yep, okay, just different angle of it. Once again, hands the camera off, the fictional camera, and he snaps that picture. Man, that's some participation there when you get the other team in on it as well. 5-0 Yankees as this ball is teed off. Where'd this go? Center field? Left center field? Yeah, he's gone. Back into the shrubbery. So, 2-for-2. A single. A home run. He's got 3 RBI already, 3 of the 5. Detroit has made it a 5-2 game. Goes down and gets this one in the zone, and he's going to go ahead and get another single. So he's got 3 hits in this game as the Yankees desperately looking for a win. Broadway, if he has anything to say about it, they are going to be well off here in their pursuit for that because he has 3 hits. However, you got a double play erasing base runners right there. Broadway got to head on back to the dugout as they get the twin killing. So how about this? This struck me. Mike Trout is a Detroit Tiger wearing number 46. How odd does that look? I know we're well into the future here, but that that just looks odd. Mike Trout in a different uniform wearing a random number. This ball hits on the line, and whoops, Joe, you kind of dove the wrong way right there. He dives in towards home plate as the ball goes down the line. I don't know if he didn't see that off the bat well, but it is an RBI for Trout. It's a 5-4 ball game now. As I don't know that Broadway gets that either way, but yeah, your dive was misplaced there, Joe. Got to work on that a little bit. Maybe that next time that fielding training comes up, take that into account. But the Yankees, they make it 8-4 now. They've extended the lead back to four runs, but that is a strikeout as Broadway is not able to connect. You see the replay and you see where this was in the zone up and... He climbed the ladder, just could not make contact. So, 3-for-4, the home run and the two singles. Still a very successful day. Oh, man, this got close. 8-7 now. Tigers not going away. Broadway, in the meantime, is going to get his fourth hit of the game. His third single worked that 2-0 count, and the pitcher had to come across the plate with something. And he just goes ahead and takes that right back up the middle for a single. His fourth hit of the game. All right. On base now. Only up one. You got two outs. And now you got three outs. Strike three swinging. Inning is over. That's Tanner Roark on the mound. And he collects the strikeout. So in a wild 8-7 game, who's going to get the last of this as we go to the bottom of the ninth? Do you feel it coming here? Do you know what's going to happen? Do I even have to say it? The Tigers walk off and beat us for the third straight game in a row. The Tigers get the walk-off. Are you kidding me? Tanner Roark holds things at bay long enough for the offense to come through with a 9-8 victory. They walk it off, and it was actually extra innings. It was the bottom of the 11th where the walk-off occurred. Oh, brother. We now have to avoid a four-game sweep by going out and salvaging one game. We are now indeed 20-30, putting us 10 games below 500. The New York Yankees are scuffling this year. And if we don't turn things around quick, there's going to be no pennant race for us this time around. Last year it was neck and neck with the Red Sox. Had all of that drama, as well as Broadway chasing the home run record, which he eventually broke. The only thing broken right now is the entire Yankees ball club, as they're up 1-0, but this is a very nice stop at third base. How about that? He just rolls over, doesn't even get up, and fires the throw on over in time to get Joe. Detroit says, forget that 1-0 lead. We'll make it 3-1. This ball hit hard, and the second baseman cannot make a play. It's on out to right center for a single. So he's got on base now, hoping that whoever's behind him can maybe hit one in the seats and tie this thing up. He is taking off with the pitch. Ball hit in the air. Ball is going to eventually just come down lazily. And the fly ball is caught. Inning is over. Yeah, they do not come through with a big blast to tie it up. We remain at 3-1. Trying not to get swept. We need to do something about that. How many chances are we going to get in the batter's box to make a difference today? It's 4-1, but the bases are loaded. Bases loaded situation. Did he do it? Oh my goodness. It is out of here to left center field. The grand slam. Oh. Oh my, we're cartwheeling. Okay. I love it. Check that out. I don't think the pitcher's going to like that too much. Broadway absolutely beside himself that he hit the grand slam here. Oh, secret handshake going on at third base. That was huge, and he's got a whole host of Yankees waiting to see him at the plate and congratulate him there. One swing of the bat, they go from down 4-1 to up 5-4, and that is the danger of having that man in your lineup. The danger to other teams of Joe Broadway's bat hitting those Broadway bombs, and that was a huge spot. Maybe that'll spark the team here. Maybe that they'll look back and see that as a huge moment. I don't know. This ball is hit out to center field and will be caught, so we'll remain at 5-4 through this at-bat and through this inning. We go to the bottom of the sixth and beyond. And our buddy Mike Trout is up again, having a nice game, 2-for-2 already. Let's see if it's hit our way that we can maybe make a play down the line this time. Okay, he doesn't dive the wrong way, and that is very close at second base. Bang, bang play, they'll give it to him. The out and the inning ends right there. Still 5-4, the Yankees in the lead. Does Broadway have another at-bat in this game? He does indeed. He comes up here already having hit the home run. He's got 5 RBI in this game. Holy smokes. Well, yeah, one of that was on a grand slam, 4-1 swing. So Yankees up 7-4. This is crushed on a line drive to left, and oh my goodness, that got out of here quickly. Second home run of the game, and it's now 8-4, and he is going fast backwards right there. Tanner Roark, you know, he got a win the other day because he hung around, and he's getting abused a little bit right now. Once again, they pull off the camera trick, and we come on over to touch the plate, and wait, what's he doing? He's dragging the leg. Oh my goodness, he's clowning around now. Okay, I haven't seen that one yet. He touches home plate with his back. All right, let's check out the replay. And it was a line drive smash. That one certainly did not take long to get over the fence, and the Yankees, thank goodness, avoid a sweep. They win finally in game 4 of the 4-game set to avoid absolute disaster. Instead, it's just 3-4. That hurts as well. So when we come back, we'll look for wins against the Philadelphia Phillies. But first, the Baltimore Orioles for 3. Baltimore, Philly, and Toronto coming up next. We'll see you next time for our buddy Joe Broadway.